climate change. Old people, when we speak to them, they rejected because they were people who lived with the environment. They know how to take something from the environment without damaging them. It was a tradition by our ancestors because they know if you want to cut down a tree, you have to plant at least 3, 4, 5 trees. Then at least 2, 3 will remain for the future. The people have to take permits from the government to cut down a tree grown in their own garden. They can't just go and cut them. It's about one generation or 1.5 generations time, this kind of damage was done.
Why are you getting old? So nobody, it's a natural, nobody can stop getting old and dirty. So the water also same, even the tree same, even for you same. That is what Lord Buddha, 1, 2, 3, 4. Give 5,000 rupees.
Yeah, when I was in my home, early morning, after bed, I heard some noise in outside my home. The people say, tsunami, tsunami, tsunami. But I don't know the tsunami that time. And every people going to outside to home to bring the package and get afraid and etc. etc. This place before more mangrove and after the tsunami very less. Okay. It's now getting better. Okay. Because we have to replantation mangrove project. But the 99% age is successful.
It was highly discussed when tsunami happened because if you cover the forest cover, not only mangroves, and there are some other species as well. This kind of mangrove forest has worked as a conservation barrier. There are some areas which the community is involved and grow a lot of mangroves. If you see that experience in Sri Lanka, whenever the disaster happens,
government try to use the army or air forces, any kind of forces to evacuate the people. He saw disaster happen in Sri Lanka, the tsunami in 2004. You can't keep people evacuating. So what you have to do is to build community resilience and also motivate people how to deal with that kind of disasters. In that case, we know that in this year there are a lot of predictions about floods and also the droughts. I think drought has already begun. There's so many areas, a lot of effect happened to the cultivation, and also the people already suffering from the scarcity of water to cultivate. We having some problems with generating hydroelectricity. So those are the issues that we will be facing in the recent future. So that's what we try to do, is to lobby and advocate with the government to provide the necessary infrastructure for the communities, especially in the deprived communities or the people who are vulnerable to that. So if you have money, you can always buy water, but there are people who can't buy it. So we are very against the privatization of water. We say that none of the forest, wildlife, water or mineral resources not to be sold, that has to be sustainably used for the benefit of the communities in Sri Lanka. So that is our argument, and we very closely work with the government agencies, and also we are a part of International Union for Conservation of Nature, UCN, and also we do a lot of programs with UNDP and UNEP. Now moving with the coastal communities, how to mitigate with this ocean and coastal resources. So Sri Lanka is now becoming a vulnerable country for the climate change and disaster prone country because of the global situation. You know what is happening in the country, like because of this global political arena, government is giving some part of the resources to China, and then India is pressuring Sri Lankan government. So then they lease some part of the life, you know, for example, in northwestern province, the government leased land for a Chinese company to build the coal power station. Then there were some issues. They have to allocate another land for the India to build another coal power station in Sampur in Trincomalee. After tsunami, people always think there is a big vulnerability, big opportunity that they can be affected from disasters. So in that case, we call it the CBDRM, community-based disaster management programs. So we try and convince the government and convince the policymakers and convince the community leaders, whatever the development projects happen, you have to take care of the effects.